I'm Krywank from Manchester, England. Normally it's a two-piece. The drummer could not get a visa, unfortunately. So you are stuck with a extra sad solo set where I'm going to be incredibly anxious all the way through. Hopefully I'll be able to utilize that as some form of energy rather than just making a fool of myself. We will find out. I don't write set lists as a heads up, so if at any point you're like, oh, I'm really scared Krywank isn't going to play that song, just shout it, and if I know it, I'll probably play it. But I'm going to start with this one. And because I shout in that one, although it was the first request and I'm immediately shooting it down, I will play it, but I might close with that one.
Scary, I'm vulnerable and stupid, for a new embarrassment to go and tear right through me, a dependent, fruitless animal. Watch me brim with shame. This confidence I fake only makes matters worse. I am not a stallion, I am just perverse, hopeless, and docile. Day I don't remember, but the day I wished away. Tedious days punctuated by dismay. Every day feels the same. Oh, it's the routine, and it's the regret. Joke and no one laughed. Did I come across as stupid, or did I come too fast? This isn't a brave face. This isn't a brave face. This is a mask.
Stage is the only place where you can feel incredibly like hot and freezing at the same time. Oh my god. Wanted to have sex, but now we just watch DVD box sets, wasting time together. So we're no alone. When I say I love you, I really mean don't leave me. As long as you stay, I don't care if you believe me. Let's deal with this companionship just to make things easy. Don't really know you, only what you've shown me. Just let me own you and you can own me. Nothing more than a love affair with ourselves. Stick around for the sake of my mental health. Pretend like we're happy, pretend like it's good, and others can envy our boundless love. We will laugh because we trick them, and we will laugh because we suck. Endorphins are fading, the rush has died down, but convenience and loneliness keeps both of us around. We will turn off our brains when the other makes a sound. sun. World sees us as a pair, but I don't really care. But you're my status, so I will keep you there. We run away for someone more attractive in our lives, but in the meantime we'll decorate each other's sides. Love is fucking stupid, and I hate you. Nothing more than a love affair with ourselves. Stick around for the sake of my mental health. If it's not painfully obvious, I'm a bit ill and my voice is going a little bit. So if by any chance you know a chorus and you fancy joining in, that's really appreciated. But no worries if you don't want it. I know gigs are awkward as hell. I do it every day. My concept of happiness is completely based on fiction. Accustomed to disappointment from the human condition. I've been fed exaggerated emotions, and I've taken them as wisdom. Romance has torn me a new one, and now I'm sad. And now I'm sad. Try and find some self-worth. Try and fall in love with another person. Try to be loved by the earth. But when you're met with constant letdowns, it feels like things can only get worse. Expectation tore me a new one, and now I'm sad. I got told not to dwell on it and to live for the present. But living in first person is hard when you're not on a track. And if the present is a gift, then I want to send it back. And now I'm sad. Tons of wasted metaphors across the writing path. The only thing I feel honest in expressing is the fact that I am sad. So, years ago, I pretty much just used to wear black tight jeans every day and black band t-shirts, because I just didn't want anyone to notice me ever. Even though I'd go into shops and I'd find really ridiculous clothes and be like, oh, I want to wear that like a clown, that's fucking sick, I fucking love that. And I wouldn't. And I'm trying very hard to embrace the clown a lot more now and not give a fuck what anyone thinks. And that's really hard, because some people will just come up to you in the street and start being a total ass just for no reason, because for some reason people are so insecure that other people's clothing or lifestyle offends them. This song's kind of about trying to move past that, It's called Unassimilated Normie.
To prove how I both love and hate you, how some days I only want to break you. But what is broken seems a mess, at least to be the one who breaks the silence, to face alone the violence, whilst I sit and watch in safe and silent agreement. Oh, convention, now I bend at the very mention. Just keep me safe, safe some face. I'll mask all intention and desire. When my heart it bursts on fire, I wear beige on a grey day. Some routines that I avoid, I wish were habits. Some routines I avoid are wreaking havoc. It's been 10 long years, but I still suck at being an adult. I bore me, you can call me.
I can play guitar, and I'll play some songs from my first album where I couldn't play guitar. No, in my look though, I'll just play this one completely wrong, but we'll see.
I can adapt, I am adept. I will not believe this evil in my head. Time is all I have, time is healing. Remember that this is a transient feeling. This will not be the end of me. I've been through worse in this life. Sometimes it's nice to be alive. Sometimes I see a bigger picture. A mantra of clarity. Cycles of emotion, and I know someday soon I'll be happy, but that won't remain. There's always pain, but what bubbles in my brain will someday soon be replaced if I just wait. 'Cause time is all I have, and time is healing. Remember that this is a transient.
Cool. Okay, I'm gonna do the first song I ever wrote for you all. That's the one. Crywank started just over 10 years ago, the day my friend Thomas Saunders stayed up all night with me and taught me that chord. And he said, if you lift that finger, it's a different chord. And so I spent all night and I wrote two songs, which are on opposite sides of the first album because they're the exact same chords. And that's how the band started. So if it's painfully obvious that this song was written by someone who couldn't play guitar, it's because it is. Okay.
I woke up this morning wanting to cry, and when I called her I realized what, although she was honest, she spoke with her cold tongue. I broke down in the courtyard when it came to light. She broke every promise in the space of one night. She made me hate this city immediately. I thought she was something else. should forget her, but I never could. I thought that I should. I need to start thinking about the things I'll never do again. Just be glad I did them, and I'm so glad I did them. First love does not mean best love, and best friends may not mean best friends forever, but they both mean at some point, somewhere, someone did care. And their memory's still there. I know she was special, I know she was good, I know she wasn't flawless, but I know I was loved. I know she had passion, I know she was kind. So why should ending alter my state of mind? And although I find it hard to relive her, I know that I can look past and forgive her. She says no regrets, and I say don't forget. Okay, here's another rearrangement of an early one. Like a cat who's not yet used to its claws, I'll hurt anyone I try to adore. I may be stretched out over your floor, but I can't control what comes out of my pores. Did I make it too easy to hurt me? Did I make it too easy to hurt me? Did I make it too easy to hurt me? Because you didn't see struggle alone. They say that it happens. They say that nothing can be done. But how could I listen when I'm so alone? I became your helpline. You tell me the things that you do. Fall apart over him and I fall apart over you. Did I make it too easy to hurt me? Did I make it too easy to hurt me? Did I make it too easy to hurt me? Because you didn't seem to struggle.
What?
Great, thank you.
Bedroom. Is it condescending to be so
Okay, GB Leniki Komori, there we go. That's how easy it is to make a request.
Enthusiastic beyond belief. In a busy room, you're all I see. And I fear this admiration will be the end of me. Blurring the lines between what I want and what I need. Calm down, calm down. Don't let them see how fast your heart is beating. Calm down, calm down. Control your breathing. And if you don't want me, well, that's my tough luck. I think about you, but I know I'm not good enough. Have I built you up too much? Now I can't say. What's on my mind in case I go and stay away? Calm down, calm down. Don't let them see how fast your heart is beating. Calm down. Maya told me this love will be different. Maya told me this love will be good. My dad's never had a broken heart. My dad's always had my mom. Too scared to fall in love again. I'll just focus on my family, my art and my friends. again, or just focus on anything else. I wanna be academic, confident and romantic, but I just feel weird and overdramatic. Daily reminders that I'm apathetic. When you're surrounded by it, it's hard to forget. I see your straight faces in the magazines, the ones I used to read when I was 13. Now I can't sleep from all these flashbacks, caravans and geyser bands and polystyrene packs. Everything I had, I seem to have lost. And everyone who loved me seems to have forgot. Everything I want seems so far away. I'll just stay in bed for another day.
Instrument,
I'm sorry, that's on a dulcimer, not a guitar. Leech boy, sure thing. I feel like a leech to everyone around me, sure and false promises I make. I invade your existence with my dependence, leave you guilt-tripped until you take care of me. For if not, I will surely die. I don't feed or clean myself, and I'm always high, putting pipe dreams before the necessities in life. Without your help, I have no hope to survive. And now I know that sounds pathetic. That's because that's what I am. So open about my flaws, but it's all part of my plan. For if I can recognize my flaws, you'll assume I'm trying to change. I am lazy and disheartened, and I know I will remain the same. Taking all you can give me, trying to live in excess, you know, you'll make my life much easier, I'll make your life a mess. Squirm away, stupid leech boy, go and die now in the drain. You speak only of your sadness, but yet to feel true pain. As I get older, I also worsen. I used to be a better person, growing into the constant burden, introducing man child. So now I'm scared I'll lose my job because I always go in stone. If I do, will you feed me, take me in and hear me moan? If you don't, I'm on your conscience and will surely die alone. If I need to regret it as I take off your own. Oh, so useless and demanding. No, I will not help out with chores. I'll bring no money or conversation. I'm motivated and bored, staring blankly into space, absorbing all you have worked for. I'm disappointing those who think I can be more. I warn you now to avoid me. I may not bite the hand that feeds, but I wrap my lips around it, and I will suck off all the meat. You'll be left feeling used once you find out I'm a leech. I'll take all that you can give, and then I will up and leave. No shame or dignity left in me, as I scout out brand new friends to fade with my dependence and let it start again. As I get older, I also worsen. I used to be a better person, growing into a constant burden. Introducing my child.
Thank you.
Right, fall on Leghorn, then Pope Alexander. But I'm losing my voice. Why would you request Pope Alexander? Oh my God. It's gonna be wheezy. Thank you.
are not always found in fondness. And sometimes when we reminisce, it's the nuisance that we miss. Look at me now, I am a dullard. Not much to say, not much to ask. Much time has passed and I'm doing the same. Staying indoors, playing video games. I'm on a website, I'm watching TV. Dystopian sci-fi with life through a screen. I am numb to the point of no return. And I work for this lifestyle with what I earn. One meal a day, 8 cups of coffee. 1 pack of biscuits, 1 pouch of baccy. 1 drink after work, 1 bag of weed. 2 chalky beans, red bills repeat. Sad to think of what I prioritise when I list what I consume to try and stay alive. When I list the fruits of my labour, when labour is most of my life. Sad to think of what I prioritise when I list what I consume to try and stay alive. When I list the fruits of my labour, when labour is most of my life.
Succeeded. It would take like a solid 20 minutes, and I think you came here for songs and not to watch the cool mouth like trick type thing. Is it here? Do I take it out here, or am I just gonna break the whole guitar? Let's find out. I think it's here. Yeah, there's 2 sides. Hey, hey. Oh my god. I don't trust myself with anything electronic. Okay. So just pretend this bit didn't happen. Although I'm really glad to know that the guitar cutting in and out was like not in my head, because I completely thought it was, and I hear a lot of noises and see a lot of things, so I was like, oh, not right now, not during a set, don't lose your mind, but no, I didn't, so that's really good. Is this? Is that anything?
No.
No, that's... Maybe I put it in the wrong way around.
Oh!
Okay, still keep yourself in the mindset that this is the end of the song. And, you know, there's a really swift transition. You can even be really kind and pretend I did this with my mouth. And afterwards be like, oh my god, so good. Is it still nothing? Yeah, I changed it. And nothing, yeah. It's not in a good mood. But when I pull it out, it goes blah, blah, blah. I think it's definitely a battery related.
Sounds like a little better. Is that good also?
Yeah. Do you reckon the support actually? Oh, is it not making a noise? A joke? I mean, a lot of my jokes are very specific to England and might not translate so well, but I'll try my best. You'll know. Okay. Which cheese is constantly questioning when comedian Lee Evans, does that mean anything to anyone here, Lee Evans? Does it mean anything to you? It's so specific. Oh wait, no, this is still a very specific joke, but this one's maybe a bit more universal. Which dessert is made by getting a baby kangaroo and then getting loads of loaves of bread, and then smashing them around the baby kangaroo until you have a spherical shape, and then you get loads of barbed wire, and you tighten the barbed wire around a, like, breadcrumb sphere of kangaroo baby. What dessert is made like that? Rhubarb crumble. Can you believe I made that one up myself? I'm unbelievable. I actually tried a stand-up set once, and if you can believe it, it bombed. Okay. What does a toilet eat? Poo. That is stolen from a child on the internet, though. That one is not an original, and I have to be accountable for when I steal jokes from children. It's kind of a pretty deplorable thing. I think maybe if we asked the support act who had an acoustic, do you reckon they might lend us their acoustic? Does anyone have a question? What's that? The drummer. He just hates Russia. No, he's in multiple bands, and we've never had visas for anywhere before. We normally sneak into countries like baddies. But we got a visa for here, and we didn't realize you had to leave your passport at the embassy for a week. And he's in multiple bands who had gigs all around Europe with his passport, and then it became a very difficult situation, and then I wasn't going to cancel the gig, so that's why I'm here like this, breaking guitars and answering questions. But if it means anything, he's really upset he can't be here, and he sends his love to the crowd. Do you have any other questions? Okay, so we have a new album, and it's coming out in the end of spring. It's called Fist Me Till Your Hand Comes Out My Mouth. And it is a reference to the film Society, largely because I try and use... Have any of you seen the film Society?
Yeah.
You have. Well, a film. It's very good. It's someone who's very paranoid that the upper class are all having these weird incestuous orgies, and that he's not actually part of his upper class family and all this kind of stuff. And he seems like he's very paranoid. Spoiler, please cover your ears if you want to watch this film. But the final scene is, it turns out he's completely right, but all the upper class also have weird kind of sludge orgies where they all like stick their hands inside each other. And wow, it's really repulsive. It's one of the nastiest scenes you'll ever see in a film. But I really related to this mass of loads of humans kind of blobbed together as one. Like, I feel like I do not have a very constant identity. I am a conglomeration of hypocrisies, and I have all these different elements of my own identity that contradict, and when I recognize those contradictions, I'm like, I'm a hypocrite, I fucking hate myself. Why do I act like this around those people? Why do I act like this around those people? Even though it's just code switching, but whatever, I won't forgive myself for that. So, anyway, I feel like a lot of that personality mess has stemmed from being in Crywank and being in the band. And the scene ends with someone fisting someone until their hand comes out their mouth, and then they grab their jaw, and then they turn them inside out. And I kind of thought, like, to end the band is for me trying to put my mental health first, and similarly with Dan. And so I kind of want someone to take this mass of personalities that contradict, that has come as a repercussion of Crywank, and fist it and turn it inside out and make it stop.
Play the chef.
Yeah, so that's... You're trying to show me up. Don't play guitar better than me, come on.
Can you do JP?
I can.
Point of joke?
But why would you request that halfway through this song?
Okay,
I'm halfway through playing, nothing's happened. Nothing broke. Everything's fine. You just interrupted the song. It's fine. I didn't put you on the spot. But I will take your request once I finish going.
That's okay.
It also needs tuning. But maybe I'll just chill it like this for a moment. No, I'm not. That's the song I think you play. Thank you. Maybe I can just do it here. I just kind of want it louder. such a mess. This is most sets for me by myself. It's just me anxiously blabbing into the microphone too much and not playing enough songs and speaking too fast for an audience where English is their second language. So apologies for that. I will try and play more songs. This song is called JK. Also, I'm very yes, I know, I think I am a joke. I know I am a joke, I am a joke somewhere. But I don't really care, well maybe I do care. But if they know that I care, they will tell more jokes about me. Yes, I know, I'm easily provoked. I try to play it placid, but I just can't take a joke. I guess that's the part that's funny. I guess I'm a real dummy. I cannot hide my upset, I run crying home to mummy. Mummy, 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 why are they so cruel? Why do they all laugh at me when I go to school? And when I get a job, and when I leave home, and when I start a family, and even when I'm dead, mummy said, poor sweetie, what do they say after they make a joke? Do they say JK? I said no, she said oh, that's really bad. I always say JK after having a laugh. Mummy, 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 what do we do? She said, first thing tomorrow, we'll take you out of school. You don't have to get a job to start a family, would be cruel. It is such a pain to have to be related to you. Then I waited, and then I waited, then I waited, then I waited all day. But mummy never went on to say JK. I know, I think I am a joke. I know I am a joke, I am a joke somewhere. But I don't really care, well maybe I do care. But if they know that I care, they will tell more jokes about me. Okay, and not forgotten your request, even though you've requested about four. But you know, you're being precocious, I like it. So here's the one that is going to ruin tomorrow's set because I'll lose my voice. Please do. My brain. My brain would never let me forget you. It's not like you lay. If there were a computer, I wonder if I'd delete you. Just because I know you wouldn't need to. At times, it feels like I'm pushed against the wall at the back. Why don't you ask any questions? Do you really not care now? Do you just talk about restaurants and the names you barely know? I try to make myself not care, but at night you're still there. You might be a chapter in my life, but you're still the star of my dreams. I love so good. You see the boundaries of politeness. You see my fists getting clenched. I aim for my bed. I spend the night beating the shit out my mattress. My brain will never let me forget you. It's not like you linger. It's more like you're haunting. Thank you. a tab website before I go on stage.
Maybe now you can.
Oh. Okay, okay. I'm going to do 7 more songs. I'm going to try and do some of the ones you've just requested, but they are very shouty. I will do Spiral Galaxy.
Yeah. Probably it's a better idea, but can you play Now I'm Sad one more time?
I'm going to try Spiral Galaxy. The chorus to this song is just screaming, which I really obviously not do. If you just want to scream or boo or do whatever you want in the chorus, I'll be going, ah! And then after like a few seconds of that, I might pretend I'm screaming and just be like, and just hope that you can create some volume. Okay, this is actually one I'm quite happy to play, because when the band finishes, I'm doing a musical, and this is the first song on the musical. So, I hope you like it. Just to remind you, please scream in the chorus. Like, make any noise. Even if it's like a quiet one, it will help. I got sight of blitz of faces, I'm willing to confess to any empathy, endlessly, incessantly declining any pleasantries. Heavily breathing, slow, teething, I'm open like a vivisection, intense tendency to dwell, teething over misconnections, affected by my perception that I'm an entity, project my insecurity until intensity is weaponry. Weaving a heavenly fiction I perceive while I was feet awake, communing, weaving fundamentally, I'm still believing that this is an elegy for concepts I conceived in deep sleep, but I helplessly watch and fable, I'm awake to try and keep them alive. Comparable with life, but eventually they die in the brain I used to cultivate reveals my lovers were alive. Do I dare admit the full force? Give one resorting in a directed mourning for the part of me that was selfless but left without a warning. Well, that's what I said. Maybe it's the fact that I detest this obsession with myself that leaves a mess inside my head. Oh shit, I'm doing it again. Repelling any potential friend, revealing my innate ability to never fully comprehend anything bigger than myself. But in the end, I'll still pretend, condescend to unpolite enough to choose to misspend the time watching me as I achieve my secret social mission to train people with my boring stories and opinions. To see the bigger picture takes intelligence and wisdom, but I won't see nothing but just myself in my vision. Reality, to lucid dream, I decimate limitations of actuality. Capacity practically eternal, mortality external. No God, but investigate the blasphemous worship of nocturnally. Journal existing without morality creates profanity without the travesty. Compare the absolute real as I feel my own insanity. The majesty of fantasy protects me from tragedy. The might is effect, reject the agony of rationality, but thankfully penetrates with no veil to my own reality. My elaborate design, privately owned, spiral galaxy. Financially, I'm failing, naturally decaying. Soon I'll have no place safe to sleep, these bills still need paying. Just playing grins, open eyes for something mind expanding. For when I drift away, I see the totality of understanding. Those two are already in the four. I'm like, oh, I'll put them at the end of the set. So I will play those. So I'll do Doubt and. Cool, I might just do one that I want to do. Sick.
Maybe Waste?
Okay, I'll do Waste.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to start with Doubt just because I fuck up Doubt every time I play it. I played it 4 times, cried twice, and it was very embarrassing, and got it wrong twice. So if I cry, it means I'll probably get it right.
Yeah.
I fuck it up every time I see.
isn't love. Do you have a choice? Not yet found a voice to answer that with. Well, if I could identify with anything, it would be doubt. Let's give a name to my everything. Let's call it doubt. Any other name I accept, it will soon feel like performance. Only the doubt is enormous. I doubt by any other name, I doubt. I doubt the words spilling out my mouth. I doubt I care, I doubt I don't care, I doubt. And now I don't think I'll reach a point where the questions end. Yeah, there's always another. And sometimes we pretend that we have the answers. Yeah, we're just a bunch of chances. I am doubtful, I am doubtful, I am doubt. I am doubtful, I am doubtful. It's as if I believe the more that I squeeze this pillow between my thighs, the more likely the chance that I'll find romance if it somehow became alive. I share my bed with a bad brain, spill ash and cum stains almost every night. I find me a drug to replace the love that is slowly leaving my life. Substitute self-gratification. A climax is a sigh. Distance myself from more conversation. Where is my mind? No, it's annoying when my head drifts away. Myself, I'm ironic, and I guess that might be true. If nothing compares to something platonic, if you want me to go, you know I will. If you want me to go.
Every night when I play this song, because it like starts with the worst chord ever.
Seems far too contrived. What are your intentions? I'm ashamed by mine.
One thing that's good about playing with Dan is he stops me from speaking. And like right now I notice there's a camera right there, hi. And there's like other people holding up cameras. And like I'll play gigs and I'll not think, I've got no filter between my brain and my mouth. And afterwards I'll go on YouTube and I'll rewatch. And like it's cringy enough, like rewatching like a video of you performing a song. But watching a video of you in front of a crowd trying to talk from the top of your head, it's always cringy. So if you have editing skills and you want to edit this out, then that would be a lovely dream. I don't fake being self-taught. I've gone out, I have no fucking clue. I don't even know any chords. It's up, still.
Now down.
Now down. You know. You're on. You're my tuner. A little bit down more? Okay, I've got three more songs for you. You've been a really, really lovely crowd. Thank you for tolerating the fact that, I mean, you probably expected it based on my online presence and how all the albums sound, but thank you for tolerating what is just an anxious mess live on stage. Here is... we also have t-shirts for sale. They're 1,000 rubles, rubly, rubello, rubobula. There are 1,000, which sounds like a lot. So if you only have 900 or 800, I'll probably let you off. Ooh, okay, let's try. Let's see how it goes. It's off now. Oh, the fuck? Shit, I totally can't change. Same note. Hey, that's exactly what I use. Oh my god, how embarrassing. I mean, I also don't have phone charge, so. Oh no, it doesn't do dad fad, so it's impossible to use the guitar tuner, which is why I started doing this on stage, just like this. Oh my god.
Yeah.
knew this was gonna happen. Okay, I am just gonna play.
Flattering attempts at making some sort of
sense,
striving for significance in a universe that will not
give a shit.
The myth of Sisyphus. Authenticity is important,
but I'm not sure who I am anymore.
I'm at the point now where I'm also
doubting who
I was before. The arbitrary nature of thought leaves me alone and paranoid. Synonyms for a void.
Trivial,
pick up pointless projects. My brain sick with vitriol.
to kind of tune it during the song. I'm going to close on a way easier one to avoid that happening again. You've been a really, really, really lovely crowd. Thank you so much to Stop the Silence Promotion for putting us on. Thank you so much to everyone working the venue tonight, behind the bars, engineer, even cleaners, everyone who's come down from travel long distance to come to this show. I hope it wasn't the worst thing you've ever seen. And it was a refreshing cringe rather than one that was physically painful. Okay, here's the last song. It's called It's Okay, I Wouldn't Remember Me Either. Thank you for being such a lovely person. To end reality, but I feel hesitant, optimistic that the future will be more concerned than the present. And so for today, I'll remain in touch. Thank you, I've been growing.